Hello, everybody. I'm going to walk us through the Excel document, which has the spherical law of cosines and the Haversine formula printed right in there for you to download. First, we will search for Haversine formula in Excel. This is me bragging a little bit. The number one result right now on Google is a link to my blog. Now, if we scroll down to the bottom here, we'll see a Google Sheet. Anybody should be able to get into this Google Sheet. It is locked for editing, but you can download it as an Excel file, which will give you all of the formulas right here. I'll walk it through quickly. So two locations, location A and location B, in latitude and longitude, they are converted into radians over here, which you can ignore, but this is important for the formulas to work. I have four formulas for distance metrics. There's the Haversine formula, which is the most accurate formula for distance. There is the spherical law of cosines, which you can see in the formula bar up here as a much smaller formula, as so is less computationally intensive, and so will allow you to scale these metrics much more if you want. Then there are a couple of other much simpler examples of distance metrics. There's the Pythagorean theorem, and then the spherical implementation of the Pythagorean theorem right here. Now, for the first two, the Haversine and the spherical law of cosines, what is the difference between them? I have a comparison chart here, which shows that for distances under 10 centimeters, you will see there's a 20% difference in the calculation of the spherical law of cosines distance and the Haversine distance. The Haversine distance is the accurate one, or more accurate one in this case. And so you can use this to determine whether or not you want to incur the computational cost of the Haversine formula when using your Excel spreadsheets, or you want to go with the simpler and faster spherical law of cosines. Thank you very much.